Good happy Sunday evening, everyone. I'm Riley King, and welcome to my news report right here on the Riley King Network. Let's begin. At least 27 dead, more than 24 injured in shooting at rural Texas church. Let's take a listen to the video from ABC News.
This is an ABC News special report.
Hey, good afternoon. I'm Tom Yamas in New York. We interrupt regularly scheduled programming to bring you breaking news out of Texas, where there has been a church shooting. County commissioners in the area tell ABC News that they're getting reports from the scene of 20 to 24 people dead. This happened at the First Baptist Church in Sutherland Springs. These are images that are just coming into our newsroom right now. Sutherland Springs is about 40 miles southeast of San Antonio, a very small and rural town in Texas. At least two hospitals in the area have been told to expect several patients. Our affiliate, KSAT, reporting that the alleged shooter is dead and that the threat has been eliminated, but this is still a very active scene, as you can see. KSAT also reporting at least six helicopters have been called in to transport victims. We do know this, that there was an 11 a.m. service scheduled for today, and before that, there was Sunday school at 9:45 a.m. We understand from eyewitnesses that the shooter came in around 11:30 a.m., right in the middle of that service, and opened fire. Senior Justice Correspondent Pierre Thomas has been working this story since it first broke, and he joins us now live. Pierre.
Tom, just a horrific situation. We have multiple sources telling us at least 20 have been killed, as many as 30 wounded. Shooter, according to our sources, is dead. Law enforcement from the federal government is descending on the scene. FBI, ATF, multiple agencies descending on the scene. No information yet on the identity of the shooter, but again, sources describing just a horrific scene. At least 20 dead, believed, and 30 wounded.
I know you've covered several of these mass shootings because so many of them have been happening over the past few years. What's a little different about this one in this case, it's that it happened in Sutherland Springs, Texas, a very small town. By some estimates, the population there under 1,000 people. We could have up to 25 people dead. And this happened in a tiny Texas church.
Yes, we have seen mass shootings in every conceivable location. This is the second church-related shooting with mass deaths. In the last 3 months, I believe. It's a situation where we had that horrific shooting in Charleston a few years ago. So this has been occurring with frequency. We don't know the why just yet in terms of whether this is terrorism, whether this is some sort of incident specific to that church. We just don't know those answers yet. But, Tom, we have a situation where these kind of mass shootings are happening with more and more frequency across the country.
Pierre Thomas for us. Pierre, thank you. I want to bring in our chief investigative correspondent, Brian Ross. And Brian, we were just covering the Las Vegas mass shooting where 58 people were killed. That was about a month ago. We had the terror truck attack in New York just this past Monday, and now this.
Exactly, Tom. An ugly cycle of violence that's very hard to explain. There's still no cogent reason to understand what happened in Las Vegas. And in this case, the same questions will be asked again and again. Why? So far, no claims of responsibility from any group of any sort. And that's something the authorities will have to sort out shortly.
I do want to read on air right now a statement from Governor Greg Abbott of Texas. Our prayers are with all who were harmed by this evil act. Our thanks to law enforcement for their response. I want to bring in Brad Garrett briefly, a former FBI agent and ABC News contributor. Brad, when you see these images on the air right now, these live pictures coming into ABC News, it is a small Texas church where this man allegedly opened fire. What crosses your mind?
That it's probably somebody local that everyone in the church knows, which is helpful, obviously, from an investigative standpoint. My guess is that they know a lot about him at this particular juncture. But keep in mind, Tom, we don't know what kind of weapon, but if those numbers are accurate, you're talking automatic or semi-automatic assault rifle or a number of pistols. So the guy obviously went there well armed to commit such a horrendous act.
Brad Garrett, our thanks to you and our team. Again, if you're just tuning in right now, we are following breaking news out of Texas where there has been a church shooting at the First Baptist Church in Sutherland Springs, just outside of San Antonio. County commissioners in the area tell ABC News that they are getting reports from the scene of 20 to 24 people dead. We also know several more have been shot. We're going to have much more details as they become available on abcnews.com, and we'll have much more tonight on World News. We now return to regularly scheduled programming. I'm Tom Yamas in New York.
Okay, and there you go on that report from ABC News. And that does it for my evening news report right here on the Riley King Network. I hope you all have a great rest of your Sunday night, and I'll see you back here tomorrow with more news. Good night, everyone. Bye.